This is part 3 of a video tutorial that demonstrates how to model an object in Maya that matches a real-world scale. In part 2 of the tutorial, I demonstrated how to use Photoshop and take two images and align them so that the front and side views would be registered and match the same scale. In this part of the video tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can take those images into Maya and use them as reference images to model your object to scale. So I've got a copy of Maya open here, and the first step that I want to do is take the images that were created in part 1 of the tutorial, take those images out of Photoshop, and bring them into my current Maya project directory. So here I am in my current Maya project, and there's a folder in here called Source Images. And what I want to do is take the front JPEG view and the top JPEG view, and I'm going to drag and drop those to copy them into the source images folder of the current Maya project. And now when I go back to Maya, I'll be able to reference those images in my current project. So in order to bring those images into the current Maya project, I'm going to launch my Hypershade window. So I go to Window, Rendering Editors, and Hypershade. And in the Hypershade interface, I'm going to switch over here to the Cameras tab. If I double-click the front shape node, it brings up the attribute editor for the front view camera, the orthographic view. So I can scroll down here to the bottom where it says environment, and I open that up and I click on create next to image plane. And that allows me to place that one of those images directly into there. Now if I scroll down in the image plane, right next to image name, I click on the input next to image name, and I can choose the wine front image to add that as an image plane for that camera. I'm going to repeat that process for the top view as well. So I'll double click the top shape, and again open up the environment section, click on create, and in the input node for image name I will now select the wine top JPEG and open that. Now when I come in here and I close the Hypershade window, you can see the two image planes are lined up on top of each other. And the interesting thing here is that the origin of the grid in Maya is matching the orientation of the photographs that we exported from Photoshop. So the center of those guides that we put in Photoshop are aligned perfectly to the origin in the world space of Maya. And that means we have less work to do in Maya, and so we can start modeling with our image planes already aligned to the origin of the world space. So in order to start modeling the wine glass at the origin, I'm going to move these image planes back out of the way. And I can do that by selecting one of the image planes. I'll choose this front view. And with that selected, I can go to the channel box. And I want to push that backwards away from the origin so that I can actually put the model of the wine glass at the origin. So I'm going to click on Image Center Z and highlight that. And then in my window, I'm going to click the middle mouse button and just drag that back so it's a little bit out of the way and off the origin. I'm going to do the same thing with the top view and just push that down so it's not in the middle of the world space. In order to do that, I'll select Image Center Y, and again, middle mouse click and drag that so it just drops it down a little bit there. Now that I have each one of these images inside of Maya, I want to match the scale inside the image that you see in the rulers of the photograph. I want to match that to the scale of the grids in Maya. Each one of these grid units is equal to 1 centimeter. So I want to scale up these photographs so that these tick marks on the centimeter ruler actually line up with each one of the grids in Maya. And again, we can do that by selecting the image plane and scrolling down to the width and the height. So if I switch here to my orthographic view for the top view, and I want each of these to scale up, I can come here to the width and type in 27.7. And when I hit that for the scale on the height and the width, I can move my view around and just temporarily offset these so that you can see now that each one of the hash marks on the ruler is lining up with the grid units inside of Maya. So simply by changing the scale of the width and the height of the image plane, I now have a photograph that matches the scale of centimeters in Maya. So I'm going to do that not only with the top view, but I will also do it in the front view as well. I'll select that image. And again, type in the same coordinates, 27.7. And now this should align also. Now that I'm in this view, I would like to set the base of the wine glass to be at the origin of the Maya world space. So I'm going to select on the image center Y and middle mouse click until just about the base of the wine glass is sitting right at the origin. And that looks good to me there. I can zoom back out. Now I can start the modeling process. And since this is a simple revolve shape of a wine glass, I'm going to use NURBS curves and then use the revolve tool to make the NURBS geometry. So I'll zoom in and start down here at the bottom. So I'm going to come in here to my Create menu and choose CV Curve Tool. And if I open up the option box, you can see that it's set to 3 cubic for the curve degree. And what that means is when I create a curve, it takes 3 points to make the roundness of the curve. If I want to make a hardened point, as I do in this demonstration, I'm going to click 3 times to make one hard point. 1, 2, 3 points. And create the first curve. And then as I continue to click around, I'll click 3 more here, and that creates the second part of my hard curve. And now I can start to go around the outside. So the trick to modeling with NURBS curves is the fewer points you use, the better it is. And so I'm just going to create a simple outline here. And I'll go 1, 2, 3 here, and then 1, 2, 3 there. And then I'll continue up around the shape of the glass, using as few points as I can. I'm going to zoom into the edge here and go around the inside, and then come back down. And then finish off with 3 more points at the center of the stem. And there I've got my profile curve that I can now go in there and start to tweak. The first adjustment I want to make is to take these end points of the curve and harden those so that they snap to our origin at the center of the scene. So I'm going to go into component mode here so I can see those CVs. And I'll select all 3 of those end CVs that I just created there. And I want them all to snap to the origin. So the first thing I want to check here on my transformation tools is if I go into my Move Tool option box, one of the things I want to make sure is that the setting for retain component spacing is turned off. I want to make sure that each one of those points, when I move them, they all snap together as a group. So I'm turning off retain component spacing. And now, with those selected, I can move them. And if I hit the Snap tool, they all snap together. So now all 3 of those points are snapped one on top of the other. They're all snapped on top of each other. And I can move that point to the origin again by snapping. Now it's snapped to the center line. And if I want to move it up a little bit to get it to the base of where the wine glass is, I can do that. And now I can start to move each of these other points to try to follow the silhouette of that curve. Here's another set of 3 points. I'll select those and move those and snap them to a point. And now I'll go down here to this other point as well. Select all 3 of those, snap those to a point. And what I'd like to do is, because the stem of this glass is straight, I'm going to select both of these groups and then click first on this arrow. You can see how I'm dragging them together. Now, if I press the X key and snap them, now they're vertically snapped so that they are always aligned. So I can now push those back so that they align with the stem of the wine glass. I can start to push those around some more. And then I'll do that one more time with the base of the wine glass. Select all 3 of those points, press the X key, snap them together. And now I can snap that to the origin. And then these 3 points, I will also snap those, press the X key, and then snap those up to the baseline of the wine glass as well. So with the X key, these 2 points are now aligned as well, and I can use my arrow key to pull that right over. Now the only thing left for me to do is to go around and move each one of these points so that they follow the silhouette of the photograph. So I can move each one of these points around. Again, I'm using my middle mouse button to try to get those points to line up with the silhouette of the photograph. All I have to do now to make a revolve surface was select that curve, and I'm going to go into my surfaces menu and choose surfaces revolve, and that will create a three-dimensional shape of the NURBS curve that I just created. And I can show you that here by switching over to the perspective view. You can now see that there's a 3D shape of the wine glass based on that curve. So I can turn on shaded view and wireframe on shaded. And then the last step that I'll show you here is just confirming that the scale in Maya matches to the scale of the photograph in centimeters. So what I'll do is go back to my front view. And from my front view, I'm going to use the distance tool. So it's create, measure tools, and distance tool. And I'll create a using the X key, I'm going to snap to the grid here at the base of the wine glass, and then I'll create another one up here close to the top of the wine glass. I can just come in here and zoom in a little bit more and move that so that it roughly matches the height of our wine glass. And now if I go back and open up our original reference photograph of the wine glass, you can see the top of the wine glass is right around 21.5 centimeters high. So if I go back into Maya, and I can actually select that image plane again, and I toggle that off, the visibility of that, if I select the image plane and go into the attribute editor, here under RGB, if I select that to none in the display mode, it will turn that off. And when I highlight our distance and dimensions, you can see that it is roughly 21.5 centimeters in height. So the scale and dimensions of our geometry inside of Maya are matching the scale and dimensions of our original reference photograph that we used to model it from. So if you use this technique, you can always be sure that your geometry that you model in Maya will match your photographs at a one-to-one relationship.